Chairman. Can I just show you one slide here, Mr. Chairman? Welfare cases in Kuwait from 2017 to 2022. Let me just show this, Mr. Chairman. Remember, and Senator Jingoy, we talked about this during your privilege speech. Nagkaroon ng deployment ban ng 2018 of February, nilift ulit ng May 2018. Nagkaroon ulit ng deployment ban 2020 ng January, nilift ulit after a month, February 2020. Pero tingnan niyo po yung total cases. Okay? 2018 from 6,000, 2019 bumaba 5,000. Okay, nilift na. Pagdating ng 2020, nag-ban ulit tayo. Pagkatapos nating mag-ban, ayan na naman, 4,900. After, anong nangyari 2021? Yung cases po, lumago na naman, 13,351. So again, Mr. Chairman, I don't have the answer right now, but there seems to be something wrong with our policy. For example, itong Kuwait, another question. Yung labor law ng Kuwait, yung household service worker natin, hindi sila, correct me if I'm wrong, and please explain to us yung specific provision of the labor law of Kuwait, which protects foreign workers. Yung Kuwaiti labor law also apply to household service workers, pero iba ho yung pagtingin nila. So, again, yung kafala system still exists? Kung may kafala system that still exists, kailangan pa rin ba? Because in our policy right now, Mr. Chairman, checklist lang po eh, checklist, checklist. Pagka may ganito yung Kuwait, check. Pagka may ganito yung Kuwait, check. Pag may batas na ganito, check. Pero ano nangyari? Ba't lumobo pa rin? And I'm not blaming anyone. I'm just saying there's something wrong with our policy. Deployment ban, lift. Deployment ban, lift. But look at the numbers. Numbers don't lie. Alas doble yung ano po natin. So I wanted to ask ang sa assessment po natin. No? Let's just be specific lang. Ng bansang Kuwait, what's our assessment really?